Hi, I'm Stu from HiveMind Automation, and welcome to The Hive. In this video, we'll be taking a look at the PrusaLink Home Assistant integration. We'll go through gathering the information that we need for the integration from our printer itself, and then we will set up the integration with Home Assistant and take a look at what it enables us to do. So while I roll the intro, why don't you take a moment to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you get notified when I release new videos each week. While you're at it, if you like what I do here and you want to support the channel, there's affiliate links to smart home gadgets you can buy for your own smart home projects and support the channel at the same time without it costing you any extra. Or you can support the channel directly through my Buy Me a Coffee link. Of course, affiliate links and my Buy Me a Coffee link can all be found on my website, hivemindautomation.com.au. With all of that out of the way, let's get started. So in a previous video, I went over a build log of my Prusa Mark IV 3D printer. And I mentioned in that video about the PrusaLink built-in printer management option and that it has a Home Assistant integration as well. So we're going to take a look at how we can set up that PrusaLink integration into Home Assistant and what that then does for us. We'll also take a look at an automation idea that I'm using in my production instance that helps me out a lot with managing my prints. Now, in order to set up the PrusaLink Home Assistant integration, you are obviously going to need to have connected your PrusaLink enabled printer to your home network, whether that's Wi-Fi or Ethernet. In my case, my Mark IV has both Wi-Fi and Ethernet available. I can't comment on the Prusa Mini or the Prusa XL at this time. Now, I'm not going to go through connecting your printer to the network. There's knowledge base articles on the Prusa site for that, and I'm sure that there's videos from 3D printing YouTubers that will show you how to do that as well. What we are going to do is go through getting the username and password for PrusaLink from the printer, because you're definitely going to need those, and we'll grab the IP address. So on our main screen of our printer, we're going to select settings, and then in here we'll scroll through to find network, and in there we'll see that our PrusaLink and Prusa Connect options are right at the very top. Further down, we've got our default setting. My printer was set to Wi-Fi, so I click that and it changes over to Ethernet. So after fiddling around in here for a few moments, my IP address shows as 192.168.1.88, and you're going to want to take note the IP address on your printer. We also have a MAC address showing in here, but I'm going to ignore this one because it seems to be for our Wi-Fi. I'm also going to scroll all the way down to our Ethernet settings. And we can see some more detail in here, like the protocol, which shows as IPv4. Now, I tried clicking this off camera and it didn't change anything at all. So I suspect that this might only be accessible if we were to turn off DHCP and choose a static IP. Speaking of that, DHCP is the next option down and you can change that to static, but I can't really think of a situation where you might set this to static, unless maybe your router has limitations where it doesn't allow you to set up DHCP reservations. We have the IPv4 address in here, which again is 192.168.1.88, and the IPv4 subnet mask. We've also got the gateway address. And lastly, as I mentioned before, the MAC address shows up here as well. And this is the one that we would use for a DHCP reservation for the Ethernet adapter. All of the same info would be in the Wi-Fi menu item if you were using Wi-Fi. I do 100% recommend that you set up your network router to have a DHCP reservation for your 3D printer, or alternatively, you can set your printer up with a static IP address. If you don't do that and your printer or router end up rebooting or both at the same time, you may end up with a different IP address on your printer and then your integration is going to stop working. Ask me how I know. I'll back out of this menu and we'll scroll back up to the top and we'll grab the PrusaLink menu. And when we open that up, it's pretty sparse. We obviously need to make sure that the setting is enabled. There's a generate password button in here, which does what it says on the box. It generates a new password. It shows our username, which is maker, and we can't change that username for whatever reason. And then we see the password that shows up here, which I'm going to blur out for reasons. I could just refresh it, but it actually ends up being a little bit of a pain because I'd have to change it in Home Assistant and then also in my Prusa slicer settings, because I have set up Prusa slicer to upload my sliced files directly to the printer, so I don't have to then grab the USB stick and take it back and forward between my printer and my laptop. Make sure that you generate a password here and you take note of it, because you will need it. So once we've got our IP address, our username, and our password, and hopefully we've also set up a DHCP reservation in our router, we can head over to Home Assistant. And I've got my demo instance up here. I'll head over to Settings and then to Devices and Services. And PrusaLink should be auto-discovered in here. However, if it isn't, it's not a big deal. You can just go to Add Integration and then search for Prusa, and PrusaLink's there. And when you do that, it will prompt you to enter the details. I'm just going to hit Configure on here, and it doesn't auto-fill the host. And I feel a little bit cheated by that. I feel like if it can auto-discover that there's a PrusaLink device on the network, it should be able to also auto-discover the IP address. So we'll put in 192.168.1.88 in there, and we'll also leave our username as maker. I've just copied my password for that printer, and I'm just pasting it in there, and I'll click on Submit, and it's created a configuration for Prusa Mark IV. And it's found the Prusa Mark IV device, and we can put that into an area, and it is in Stu's office. I'll click Finish there, and we're all done. So setting up the integration was nice and easy, but you might be wondering, well, what was the point? Well, let's take a look at what data becomes available with the Home Assistant integration set up. So we'll scroll through here and we'll find our PrusaLink integration here. We'll click on that, and then we'll click on One Device, and you can see some controls and some sensors in here. For controls, they're pretty basic. We've got cancel job, pause job, and resume job, and they all do what they say on the box. Those are really only going to be active if the printer is printing here. So that might be helpful if you are printing away and you need to quickly take one of those actions. Say you've got a tablet with a 3D printing dashboard or something in your 3D printing space there, you could have those three buttons there, quick and easy, right, ready for you to use. But I'm more interested in the sensors here. So you'll note here that we've got a number of sensors and we've got 8 entities not shown. What I'm going to do, I'm going to back out here and go to 19 entities, and I'm just going to click this button here so that I can then select entities, and I'm going to select all of the entities that are not active. Anything here that has this disabled icon next to it, and then I'm going to click on this 3-dot stack here and click on enabled to enable those 8 entities. And when I back out here and then go back into One Device, it's enabled all of those there. And in a few moments, it's going to populate the sensor data for those. As we explore the sensors though, we see that the first item we've got here is a little kind of printer icon, and it's Prusa MK4. And it says that it's currently printing. It's got the file name here. So this file name entity shows that we have a fidget ring, and that's what's printing right now. If we were not printing, that would just be a blank file name. We've got our heat bed target temperature, and that's just populated from one of the entities that we just enabled a second ago. So the target temperature is 90 degrees C, and our heat bed, and it just says heat bed temperature, but that's the current temperature of the thermistor, which is at 90 C. Our hot end fan speed, again, that was one that we just enabled, and that's got the RPM speed there. The material that we've got loaded is PETG, our target temperature and current temperature for the nozzle. And we've got our preview here. Now, the preview status pretty much always shows idle, but what does change is this item here. It kind of comes up a little bit like a camera entity or a picture entity. And this is the G-code preview that you would normally see on the LCD of the printer. So I quite like that that's there, and you could have that again show up on a dashboard that you might have next to your printer or in your 3D printing space there. We see the speed of the print fan, And again, that's one that was enabled when we turned on those entities a moment ago. We've got an ETA for our print finish time, which is in about 4 minutes. We've got print flow, and that's a modifier that you can set on the printer to increase the amount of plastic that it's extruding in case you're getting gaps or under extruding. We've got our print speed, which you can turn up or down. Again, that's a manual setting on the printer. We can't change these details from here. Print start, we see, was 16 minutes ago. Our progress is 72%, and our current Z height is 5.4 millimeters. It just ticked over there. So having all of this information in Home Assistant is great and all, but you're possibly still asking yourself why. Well, there's a couple of reasons in my use case at the very least. Firstly, at some point in the not too distant future, I do plan to add a power metering plug pack to the printer to monitor the power consumption of my printer. And if I'm also able to track the stats of the printer alongside that power metering data, I can then correlate the data points to each other. For example, if I'm printing with different materials, I can see how the temperature settings would affect the amount of power that I'm consuming and understand that a bit better. To that end, it's helpful for me to have Home Assistant reading this data because I'm already passing the data that Home Assistant reads onto InfluxDB, which I can then use in Grafana to perform some data analysis on. I will be revisiting Grafana and InfluxDB at some point in the near future, so subscribe if you want to see that. The second point that I want to make in here is that I can now use these data points to trigger automations. So let's go through setting an automation up that I actually use on a daily basis in my production instance. I'll head over to settings here and I'll go to automations and scenes, and I'm going to click on create automation, create new automation, and I'm going to add a trigger here. I could use device, but the attribute that I want is not attached to the device. What I want to do is grab an entity, and I want to grab an entity state. The entity that I'm looking for is Prusa MK4, and it's this one with the printer icon we saw in the sensors of the PrusaLink integration. And when that entity changes to a state of finished, I want to trigger an automation. Now we can add a condition here. So for example, we can add time and location that we only want this to trigger after 6 a.m. And before 11 p.m. just so that we're awake. So with the conditions in place, then I'm going to add an action, and I'm just going to call a service, and I want to call notify.mobile_app_Stewie's iPhone. Scroll further down here. And what I want to do here is I'll put title 3D print finished. And in message, I'll put Prusa MK4 print job completed. So what we're going to do with this automation, when this entity changes to finished, if it is between 6 a.m. and 11 p.m., send a notification to my phone with 3D print finished as the title and Prusa Mark 4 print job completed as the message. And we'll click save. We'll give it a name, 3D print alert on completion, and we'll click save. I'll just check the status of the print job. If I go back to our PrusaLink integration here, where are you? There you are. We've got our one device and it's already finished. So unfortunately we missed that, but if I head back over to settings, automations and scenes, go to 3D print, and I'll click run there, and you'll see we get the alert on our phone. And it's also worth mentioning that being that this is going to be pushed to an iPhone, my Apple Watch will also then tap me on the wrist when a print job finishes and show me that alert as well. You could also add some additional flags in here to set this up as a critical notification so that it ends up playing a sound even if your device is in silent mode. Or maybe you could do something different, like turn a light on even to a specific color, or maybe use one of the many text-to-speech options that are available for Home Assistant. So with this automation set up, as soon as a print job finishes, I'll get an alert. That way, if I've got a few things that I want to print back to back, I can go and clear the build plate as soon as I get that notification and then kick off the next print. That allows me to then maximize the productivity of my printer. You're not just limited to this kind of alert setup though. You could also set up some other automations, say based on the temperature, and maybe one of them gets above a predefined safety threshold. You could then turn off a smart switch to then kill power to the printer and avoid starting a fire. Or, and I don't actually know if this would work, but if you were perhaps doing a multicolor print where you have to change the filament at a specific layer height, you might be able to then monitor for the message that the printer would send telling you that you need to change your filament. And then push a critical alert to your phone so that you get the sound and everything as well to then alert yourself that you need to go and change that filament. And you would then be able to maximize your productivity, reduce any kind of idle or standby time for your printer while it's just sitting there. In that scenario as well, you could potentially be saving power because you're not heating something that's not actively being printed for an hour, say, while you are distracted by something else. You'd get the alert and then you could go and change the filament. So that's the PrusaLink Home Assistant integration. I hope you see how useful this integration might be if you also have a Prusa Mark IV or another PrusaLink enabled printer. I've done a video before about Octoprint, and we can pull a lot of the same data from Octoprint as well, and then set up similar automations. I am considering re-exploring Octoprint in the near future and maybe even then doing a head-to-head comparison with PrusaLink or Prusa Connect. So if you want to see that, let me know. I'm also planning at some point in the not too distant future a video on Prusa Connect and the Home Assistant integration there. Again, let me know if that's something you want to see. As always, let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. That's all we have for this video, and I hope that it's helped you in your home automation and 3D printing journey. Be sure to comment below with a home automation idea you'd like to see me cover in a future video. And don't forget to follow Hivemind Automation on Instagram and Facebook. If you liked this video, hit the thumbs up button down below to give it a like. And if you're not already subscribed, please consider changing that now. While you're at it, if you hit the bell icon, you'll get a notification when I release new videos each week. And lastly, if you like what I do here and you want to support the channel, there's a Buy Me a Coffee link in the video description below. Contributions you make through Buy Me a Coffee are put towards making more and hopefully better content for you to enjoy. Don't forget to check out my website, hivemindautomation.com.au. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Stu from Hivemind Automation, and I'm looking forward to seeing you next time. Bye for now.